When something goes wrong, we instinctively seek communion with one another. We need to talk and sometimes listen. And the blues is structured to help us do both well. It is itself a response to life's endless hardships. Most of the ways we develop improvised material in all styles of American music is representative of how we converse with one another. But the blues makes everything so clear. A solo means you speak and hopefully everyone else will listen. When the band stops and lets you have it alone, and then they come back in to make sure that you've kept the time, that's called a break. You get to have your say, and so does everyone else. When we repeat the same thing over and over and over again, we achieve solidarity and gain strength with every iteration. We're playing riffs. Sweets Edison, the great trumpeter with the Count Basie organization, once told me that some kind of way during the Great Depression, the Basie band got into a competition with a room of dancers to see who could swing the hardest. Well, they played one riff from 3 o'clock in the morning till the sun came up, and the singers, the dancers had to stop. They said, the band beat us. Here's an example of a riff. We most often use a free call and response to encourage interactive musical conversation. Actually, the blues has more space for response than call. This forces us to pay attention to what's being said and played. You have to understand what you are responding to and whom you're responding to has to wait for you to finish and work with whatever you gave them.
Well, the 219 train took my baby away. The 219 train took my baby away. The 217 gonna bring her back one day.
Music.